Hello, welcome to Timberwolves Dynasty Game 3 against the Portland Trailblazers. I got LeBron James on their squad. I'm going to do something a little different here. I'm not going to commentate over the whole thing. I'm just going to try to avoid any music that plays during the game. I might jump in every once in a while, but I'm going to turn off commentary as soon as this gets done loading. I'm going to listen to my podcast. I'm just going to play a game in my franchise. I wish I could have been playing more of these games because I'm really enjoying this team, but I've been quite, I wouldn't say busy, just preoccupied with a lot of other things.
And Jabari Parker is the guy we'll have our eye on tonight. Head to
nothing exciting's happened in the Shaq, areas between the games. I'm still, I just tried looking for a new point guard for Michael Carter-Williams just to see what I could get for trading Eric Gordon and Michael Carter-Williams. But it turned out that it was nothing that special. I could have got Gordon Hayward, but I don't need a small forward. Okay. Please enjoy the game. I'm going to be focusing on it with my entire concentration, so I'm not going to be talking. I'm going to try to avoid all the music, like I already said, so I'm going to shut up right now. Thanks.
Last outing for Minnesota, they won that game against the Nuggets in Denver. It was just a textbook performance. That game was all there. Once they got it going, it was full speed ahead.
And even in hostile territory, as they were that day, they had no jitters at all. I mean, the confidence kept growing as the shots kept falling.
And they were falling big time. I mean, from the top to the bottom of that roster, everybody was locked, loaded, and spraying jumpers.
Let's take a look at our starters from Portland. LeBron James is out there with Markieff Morris. Then there's Bradley. Then there's Dragic. And it's Valanciunas in at the five down low. Last season for the Timberwolves, it was a struggle most of the season. Young teams tend to do that, but they didn't have, unfortunately, Greg, much luck at home.
You know, they basically limped their way to a league-worst 9-32 record at home. Part of taking your lumps as a young team. Let's see how they respond this season.
Mm-hmm. And so it's the Minnesota Timberwolves getting the first points of the ball game. The offensive rebound. The teardrop falls in.
Oh, such a feel shot there, the floater.
And about a minute gone here in the first quarter. On defense, Portland. Last game matchup with the Suns, a tough loss there.
Just not a disciplined performance defensively in that game, guys. A lot of silly fouls hurt them throughout.
I think lack of discipline is the right phrase, Greg. I mean, a lot of silly fouls, and they did that even when they were in foul trouble.
Again, the miss by Morris.
That's a shot he's got to hit. You don't get many looks better from that range.
And it's Whiteside off the drive. The Trailblazers have gone just 1-4 to get this game started. Down low, and Morris throws it down.
Give credit where credit is due right there. A terrific assist.
Minnesota with the ball. Outside Gordon. There's the pass to Cousins. Shot left block. Shot is good off the back rim and in.
How much do you love to see the turnaround?
Trailblazers have gone 2-5 here, making 40% so far to start out the game. Screened by Valanciunas. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot. And what you have to like out of Valanciunas last season, improved efficiency. The game really, Clark, seemed to slow down for him.
Yeah, he entered the league a little green. I mean, would make a lot of mistakes, but had excellent tools. So with enthusiasm and hard work, you knew it was just a matter of time with him.
And for Valanciunas last year, his offensive production was similar to the year before, but he cut down on his turnovers. He also raised his shooting percentage to a career-high 57%. And that, my friends, is improved efficiency.
And Portland has possession. Following the three by Minnesota. LeBron kicks to Valanciunas. Oh, and that one, no question, powered it down.
He always knows where his teammate's going to be, and Kevin, that will let him put the ball where he wants it, right waiting for him.
Screen by Cousins. Gordon dishes to Whiteside. Gets to the rim for two with the D all over him.
You know, talking about Valanciunas, the light clearly went on last season. He was more assertive, refined his post game. The next step is to extend his shooting range so he can help space the floor on offense.
Now, here's Valanciunas. Good work defensively by Whiteside. Here's Gordon. And a great assist by Carter Williams as that one goes in. Gordon's got his first bucket in this one. Trailblazers trail by four. LeBron with it. He's picked up by Cousins. LeBron's shot is good.
Oh, that is just weak defense there. I'm pretty sure that was not the plan to give him those kind of baskets at the hoop.
Now here's Carter Williams. He's coming off a 13-point game against the Nuggets in Denver.
And he also was a table setter in that game, Kevin. Just an amazing job with his passing. Just a joy to watch that one. And I like how he puts himself in position there to finish on the break.
Yeah, you know, that's what we call seeing and feeling the game. Excellent read of how that play was going to develop and where the ball was going. That's stuff that you oftentimes can't teach, Greg.
And the layup falls.
You know, they've scored several times already here in the first quarter down low. I like that.
It's like a running game in football. When you can pound the basketball inside, it also allows you to control the team's transition.
Jabari Parker's checked in for Damari Carroll. Portland trailing here. James outside. Screened by Valanciunas. Dragic with a screen for James. The kick out to Dragic. Good on the triple. Dragic has got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three.
Just a little confusion among the D as to who was supposed to be on it.
Parker passes to Cousins. It's hauled in by the Trailblazers.
And typically, he has the touch to finish when he's in tight, but not sure on that possession.
Screen by Valanciunas. There's the feed to Morris. And that's good. And it's Dragic with the assist.
Those are the kind of nice inside looks they've gotten in the first half here.
And I think they should continue to work the ball down low, Clark. It's really going to free up their outside shooter.
Now, here's Cousins coming off a solid outing against Denver. Hits some rim on the way in, and the bucket's good. Cousins has got his second bucket tonight.
That time the defenders were a little lazy getting to him.
As magical as the 2014 playoffs were for the Blazers, remember they beat Houston in that first round, that great shot by Lillard late to win it and move on. 2015, not as much. You know, Greg, they drew a very tough Memphis team, as you recall, in the first round.
Yeah, you often talk about styles making fights. Very similar in this series. They would go on to drop the first three games before being bounced, but still a good showing for a team that struggled mightily down the stretch with injuries.
And that one's good.
Every time they get scored on during this run, it's come from inside the paint.
Yeah, they have really owned the interior. You've got to collapse that defense and force them to beat you over the top.
Some changes for Minnesota. Horace Diaz checked in for Whiteside. Smith comes in for Gordon. And Ty Lawson subbed in for Carter Williams. An almost entirely new group here for Portland. Capella's checked in. Landry comes in for Markieff Morris. Miami's checked in for Avery Bradley. And it's Watson in for Goran Dragic.
And, you know, just as you said, Portland didn't have enough to get by the Grizzlies in the first round. Ended up losing in five after taking one game, and that was game four. Just had a hard time breaking down the Memphis defense.
James misses.
And trying to come up with the highlight reel finish, somebody forgot to finish it.
And the dunk by Parker.
Not much defense to speak of yet here, guys.
Nope. It's been all offense, fellas, all the time here early.
They set the pick. No good from Lamb.
Another loss for the Blazers when they were the four seed, as you mentioned. As a franchise, they have lost in the first round every time they have ended up as the four seed. Not exactly a good position for them to be in.
Now here's Lamb, following the miss by J.R. Smith.
That is some tough defense there against one of the better finishers in our game.
Parker kicks to Cousins, and stolen by James. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Jabari Parker. That's his first foul.
And really, these are some of the toughest calls an official has to make.
Yeah, but in this case, I think he got it right. I mean, the defender was still moving there and never really had good legal guarding position. He wasn't set.
The Timberwolves making a switch here. Brewers checked in.
And guys, they continue to put a lot of pressure on the interior defenders with the way they work down low.
It's becoming a theme in this game, Clark. They are piling up the points in the paint.
Now, here is Lawson. Dishes to Brewer. And off there, he misses his first shot of the night. Watson kicks to LeBron. And a beautiful feed leads to a monster jam.
Boy, he is such a ridiculous dunker.
High riser, no doubt about it.
Goodness, I mean, you come to expect plays like that from him, and folks, that never gets old.
Smith outside. The three. And they're scoring pretty well as we conclude the first quarter. Trailblazers out in front, leading by five. And we'll get. And of course, as we've always seen with LeBron James, it's not just about the numbers, but his. Well, that there is straight talk from a man who does not pretend LeBron James with a textbook example of how to take responsibility and lead.
And Kevin, that's why he is the king. He doesn't say, hey, I'm just one of the five guys. No, he knows who he is and what he has to do. Bottom line, he's the man. Climb on my shoulders, and I'm going to take you to the promised land.
And now the second quarter just getting set to start. And what do you guys think so far about the offensive approach for the Trailblazers?
And so far, these guys have done a fantastic job finding the open man and getting some easy baskets.
You know, we've seen them bearing their fair share of mid-range jumpers tonight, too. I mean, that's a good start for them.
They've got Damari Carroll out there. Lawson out there with Corey Brewer. Then there's Whiteside, and it's Diaw in at the power forward position. So that's the lineup for Minnesota.
Again and again, they're dissecting the defense and creating those high percentage looks from inside.
And even under pressure in close, I think they've still done a good job maintaining concentration and converting the opportunities.
Hits it from three-point range. Diaw's got five.
How can you forget about him? I mean, he's not going to miss that open of a look.
Well, I'm sure you guys have heard this, that the nickname that has been given to Damari Carroll, the Junkyard Dog, I think it's apropos. Kid drafted out of Missouri back in the 2009 draft.
Yeah, and he actually had to show perseverance to hang around as he bounced around a bit. But I think he's found a home now.
Here's Lamb. Can't get it to go. And it's the Timberwolves taking it the other way.
And the rebound and the follow show you what he is all about. Gritty and determined with a soft touch to match.
And Lawson, here we go. Let's it go with a three. The shot by Carroll, no good. Trailblazers leading by seven. Rogic kicks to Bradley. Good ball movement here by the Trailblazers. Lawson against Bradley. Lawson dishes to Whiteside. Diaw, the screen, puts up the baby hook, and Whiteside finishes it off. Whiteside's got his third basket of the night right there. The Trailblazers have gone three of their first five shots to drop here in the second quarter. Time called here. The Blazers decide to talk it over. This, their first chance to take a look at Minnesota this season.
And although they were the better team last year by overall record, this was a competitive matchup for them.
Guys, they split the season series, and you know there's always randomness to this game. The unpredictability of it. You win some, you lose some, but they certainly want to impose their talent level tonight.
No good from Lamb.
I didn't see that miss coming. I mean, he's usually been money from that range.
Whiteside with it. Now guarded by Dragic. Here's the three. Here's Cousins. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
And I like the fact that the defense is looking to protect the rim at all costs.
Definitely saved a layup with that foul, and he'll make him earn them from the line, and that's what you want to see. You know, last season, DeMarcus Cousins had several triple-doubles, but with Cousins, he would have 20-plus rebounds to go along with 20 points and 10 assists. That's amazing for a big man, for any man, as a matter of fact.
Back to Dragic. Shot clock at 5. 13 feet away. Rebounded by the Timberwolves. Cousins has got his third rebound tonight. And for Cousins, those 20, 20, 10 triple-doubles are an incredibly rare feat. First time, in fact, that we've seen that in the NBA since 2010.
And he was the first big man since the great Wilt Chamberlain to do it in back-to-back games. So Cousins is one of the rare big men who can do it all and has displayed that multiple times last season.
And Michael Carter-Williams gets the whistle that time. That is his first foul of the game. Gordon against Bradley. Pass to Valanciunas. Misses from short range.
Boy, he really bungled that finish.
And it's Gordon penetrating.
That's his first personal foul. Second team foul.
Whiteside, a screen on Bradley. Gordon, the pass to Whiteside. It's stolen by Valanciunas.
That's a hard pass to make when the defense has that many people in the paint.
And it goes out of bounds. That one's off Bradley.
Let's take a look at DeMarcus Cousins' numbers. Last season, he played outstanding. Third in rebounding, fifth in scoring, and a top 15 ranking in blocks per game, supplying that backline protection that is so key to a great defense.
And as you said, a top three rebounder last year, he just seems to know how the shot's going to come off the rim and always hustles to get there.
Jabari Parker's checked in for Whiteside. LeBron kicks to Dragic, and the whistle blows. It's going to be on Jabari Parker. That's foul number 2 for him. C.J. Watson, he's checked in for Portland. Bradley dishes to Morris. Looking to end the drought. And the dunk by Valanciunas.
And nobody, guys, among the defenders stepping up to challenge him on that drive to the 10.
And Greg, he says thank you very much and sails in for the flush.
And those are the kind of sequences that tell you why the score is what it is.
And the dunk by Parker.
How about that fantastic finish and the aggressive move, too, Kevin?
Trying to send a message, Clark, with that slam, I think.
And I'm not sure if it was text or email, but he definitely threw that one down.
Morris against Parker. Morris outside. Here's Valanciunas. Though he's been working on his offensive skills, defense and rebounding are Valanciunas' bread and butter. That was the case with him when he was playing in Lithuania, Clark, and it's the case now.
It still sure is the case. I mean, it's hard to find a guy with his combination of size, athleticism, and fluidity. Just a tad over-aggressive at times, but I'd rather have to turn a guy down than to turn him up.
Mm-hmm. Smith checked in for Minnesota. And it's Gordon penetrating. Parker with no one around. Morris with the rebound. Trailblazers leading by 4. Bradley with the ball. And it's Gordon picking him up. Morris a screen. Here's James. Bradley, no one around him. Portland again missing. Minnesota's gone 1-3 from way outside since the start of the second quarter. Screen by Cousins. And stolen by LeBron. And Valanciunas kicks to Watson. The rebound by the Timberwolves. Cousins has got his 5th rebound right now in the game. Goes up high for the two-handed dunk.
And that's how it's done. I mean, find that hole in the D and then go hard to the rack.
Maybe that hole was a little bigger than it should have been.
Well, it was. I mean, a tight game like this one, you'd think they'd have a little more energy at the defensive end than that. You know, of the last 6 baskets, 5 have come on the interior. This is major smash mouth basketball, guys.
It's all about imposing your will offensively, getting exactly the kind of looks their coach drew up.
Morris a screen. Terrific design on the pick play, and he lays it in. 8 points for LeBron.
Great job of screening there. Nice job to take it to the rim and get the finish.
It's tipped and stolen by LeBron. Now, here's Watson. He's guarded by Cousins. Bradley, and he's good on the three ball. Avery. Bradley's got his second bucket tonight.
You know, there's no better sign of how he...
Hello. Holy shit. I can't stop turning the ball over. What the fuck is going on? Just wanted to say I'm really annoyed that I keep turning the ball over. I try and pass it to one person, it goes to another person. I need to start pressing the pass indicator button because obviously it's not working for me. Alright, talk to you maybe.
If they want to make sure they don't wear down later in the game.
Absolutely. Over the course of a game, yeah, to stay hydrated.
And some changes here for the Timberwolves. Boris Diaz checked in for Cousins. Brewer comes in for Gordon. And Ty Lawson subbed in for Carter Williams. The Trailblazers also changing it up. Capella's checked in. And Carl Landry has subbed in for Morris. 59 seconds left in the second quarter. Watson kicks to Capella. They set the pick. There's the dish to LeBron. Down to five on the shot clock. Over to the left wing. Here's Watson. The rebound by the Timberwolves.
Well, I think the defense got lucky right there. I mean, he's going to make a lot more of those than he misses when he's got that much room.
Good on that shot, and with that, the Trailblazer lead is cut down to one on the bucket from Dion.
Now, that's where you like your shots to come from.
Watson, the pass to Lane. He's looking for LeBron and finds him. A nice pick right there to get him right to the rack.
And a sturdy screen set for him that time. And he doesn't fool around, just straight to the rim for the finish.
No way for his man to get around that one. That's for sure.
No chance, Kevin. I mean, the screen was in the right spot. His feet were set. He would have had to go straight through him. And that's not legal.
And the basket by G.I.
A lot of space right there to get that shot off.
Not a very good job of the defender getting over the top of that screen in that particular play.
Tie game.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Ernie Johnson here again with Kenny Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. We welcome you back to the... It was a closely contested first quarter for Minnesota. They did give up a couple baskets. And that's going to do it for now as the second half is almost ready to get...
Well, both sides have assessed what they need to do over the break in halftime. We'll see now if one can pull out away here in the third.
Looking at the game Diaw has been having, 10 points, and he's got two baskets from out in three-point land.
And I'm sure they'd like to get a few more of those out of him.
And now let's check out the lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for the second half of basketball. On the court for the Trailblazers, Markieff Morris is out there with Jonas Valanciunas. Then there's Dragic. Then there's Bradley. And it's James in at the three slot.
Yeah, you hate to give up a foul on a three-point attempt.
Yeah, unnecessary. I mean, make them earn those points from deep. Don't give them to them free at the line.
Well, Portland had another strong season against the rest of the West. Ended up with a record of 31-21 in the conference, and that was good enough to earn them the fourth spot in the West.
The Trailblazers have split their free throws right down the middle so far. They're 2-for-2. And he makes the first. Both free throws good from James. Minnesota's gone 3-of-7 tonight from three-point territory. Carter Williams dishes to Whiteside. Here's Cousins. And it's LeBron James with the rebound. Portland leading. Outside Bradley. Morris against Carter Williams. Morris with the bucket. Morris has got 8 points. Portland did end up fourth in the West, as you said, Greg. You're talking about that, and their 31-21 in conference record was the exact same as it was at the end part of the 2014 season.
Well, actually, Portland won more games in 2014 than they did last season, ended up fourth in the conference, mostly because of how they won their division.
The Timberwolves have gone 1-3 since starting the second half. Carroll, no one around him. The basket good off the assist from Carter Williams. Carter Williams has got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight. Carter Williams against Dragic. To the middle, here's Morris, and he takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed. Assisted. Morris has got the game tied up here for Portland. Timberwolves have gone 2-4 here to start the second half. Screen by Cousins. Carter Williams kicks to Cousins, feeds it to Whiteside. And it's Carroll in the corner. Clock is at 3. Gordon for 3. Rebounded by Valanciunas. Valanciunas has got 4 rebounds now tonight. Morris a screen in the corner. Bradley with it. No good on the 3. Minnesota's gotten fewer than half of their 3-pointers to go down tonight. They're 4-for-9. Whiteside, and it is flushed down with a nice jam.
And really just led him to his sweet spot for that finish.
Time called here. The Blazers decide to talk it over.
Really unfortunate for Eric Gordon that an assortment of injuries have really derailed his career. A few years back, he looked like he'd be an absolute star. Once a 22 points a game score, was down to 13 a game last season.
Lamb, he's checked in for Bradley. Just over 2.5 minutes gone by here in the second half. Carter Williams against Dragic. Here's James. And it's Whiteside with the rebound. Yeah, on the topic of Eric Gordon, one would think he's still young and talented enough to be a difference maker with any team. He just has to stay healthy. That really is the bottom line. He's got to keep his health.
Kevin, the truth is, though he's had a number of injuries, they've all been different. It isn't one chronic thing. So with a little good luck, we could see him shine once more.
Lamb passes to Morris. Shot from 12, and it's good off the glass. Morris has got 6 here in this quarter. Timberwolves leading by 3. Carter Williams with it. He has 7. Carroll with the 3. The basket good off the assist from Carter Williams. Carroll's got 2 now from beyond the arc in the third for the Timberwolves. Dragic kicks to LeBron. And it's out of bounds. The Trailblazers able to retain possession here.
Oh, nice play there to get a hand on that pass, then tip it out of bounds.
Just a whisker away from coming up with the steal there.
Morris outside. And out of bounds as the Timberwolves gain possession. Quick hands and the ability to anticipate the opening to create a turnover, so valuable, especially for a guard, as we see 2 tremendous talents with their ability to steal that ball away.
You know, and John Stockton, the only player to have cracked the 3,000 barrier in terms of career steals. You ask the fans about Stockton, and it's his passing they'll remember. But if you ask the players, he's played up against it. They'll tell you it's his defense that was just as sharp.
LeBron against Carroll. LeBron dishes to Dragic. Screened by Valanciunas. Pass to Morris. 6 to shoot. Valanciunas trying to free himself up. Out that one in, and the Timberwolves lead is cut back down to 6. They get the basket from Morris. Right side a screen. Dragic against Carter Williams. He kicks to Whiteside. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him 2 chances at the free throw line here.
Boy, last season, Hassan Whiteside made a huge splash in the NBA. Big blocks, big rebound totals. But he had some head-scratching moments as well. Missed his share of action due to suspensions.
Here's what Minnesota's going with right now. Morris Diaz checked in for Cousins. Parker comes in for Damari Carroll. J.R. Smith checked in for Gordon. And it's Lawson in for Michael Carter-Williams. And gee, as you said with Whiteside, his fiery attitude flared up a few times last season, and it hurt his team more than once in Miami.
No doubt, and it's something that he has got to work on. I mean, he's proven that he can be a big-time player in this league, but he can't have the mental lapses that get him tossed from games and hurt his team.
Smith outside. Minnesota needs to get off a shot here. Here's Lawson. Second chance shot. Whiteside, good. Whiteside's got 12.
They've been the glass eaters today, guys. A ton of effort out of them down low.
It's been a difference maker for them in this game. That's what's put them in front.
Landry with the screen. Watson, the pass to Landry. It's good, and Watson picking up the assist.
Boy, that was a rugged screen set there, fellas, and the defense didn't even try to go through that one.
Lawson outside. Diaw, the screen, and Lawson with the drive. Diaw with a wide-open look. Can't convert after the good screen. Trailblazers trail by four. James outside. To the paint. Here's Capella, and he goes strong with the one-handed jam.
Solid on the one-hand throw down there.
You know, Clark, when it's a tight ball game like this, he's the guy they want with the ball.
Yep. Yeah, and one reason why, I just don't know that I've ever seen him miss a play like that.
Whiteside kicks to Smith, goes up again, and he gets it to go. 14 points now in the game for Hassan Whiteside.
No doubt about the consistency when it comes to scoring the basketball for him tonight. A real nice lift for their offense.
Landry with the screen. James with it. He's picked up by Parker. Watson's shot is good.
And he found the perfect spot behind the arc there. Big gap in the D.
That was a good time to call a timeout to try to settle everybody down and get back into their offensive rhythm. They've been coughing up the rock an awful lot.
We've got 1:23 left in the third quarter. Lawson outside. He dishes it to Diaw. Whiteside, the pass to Smith. Just five to shoot. Back to Whiteside. It's good, the assist that time from Smith. Smith's got his fourth assist in this one.
He is just tearing it up this quarter. That lead's not going anywhere while he's this hot.
Landry with a screen for Lamb. Landry, a screen on Smith. Capella kicks to Watson. At the top of the key, Landry. Landry with the screen, Lamb, and he sinks the shot coming off the strong pick. Lamb's got five.
A lot of space right there to get that shot off.
Not a very good job of the defender getting over the top of that screen in that particular play. They're fortunate that one was just deflected and not stolen. Dodged a bullet there.
And Portland making a change here. Bradley's checked in. That's a two from Smith. And the shot falls short this time.
Well, I think he had all the space he needed. He just couldn't find the bottom of the net.
And J.R. Smith picks up the foul. That'll be his second foul of the game.
Damari Carroll.
Here's Watson.
Minnesota foul.
First trip to the line for him here.
Really a good season for him overall last year. Look at the number, 83% from the line.
You know, he really did excel at the stripe. I mean, they couldn't have asked for too much more from him when it came to knocking down free throws.
And here's Smith. Two on the clock. Can't get it to fall. And the game still closely contested. And we're set to start the action up here in the fourth quarter. And if it's anything like the first three, we should be in for a treat. Minnesota's gone to the three-pointer 11 times tonight, nailed five of them. Michael Carter-Williams is out there at court. Then there's Parker. Then it's Damari Carroll. And it's Cousins in at the five. So that's the lineup for Minnesota. James kicks to Dragic. Good, and the assist goes to LeBron. Dragic has got the fourth quarter going with the first basket of the period here for Portland. Timberwolves trail by three. Here's Carter Williams. It's stolen by Bradley. Up top, Morris. All alone. The shot misses. So Minnesota will take it the other way. It's Parker with the drive. And that one's good.
Yeah, heads up aggressive play right there. Saw the smaller man on him and took it straight to the basket.
Inside. And finished off by LeBron.
Boy, this game has really started to heat up. I didn't think it could get any more high scoring than it already was.
Well, I tell you what, I don't mind it. You don't either, it sounds like. Good offense is entertaining, and that's exactly what we're getting.
Kicks it to Dragic. Morris outside. It's Bradley on the wing. Minnesota with the rebound. Cousins has got his seventh rebound here tonight. We're just over a minute and a half now into the fourth. It's stolen by Valanciunas. And here we go. Trailblazers with a fast break. Ball's knocked loose. Fast break, Minnesota. Parker leading the charge. Shot is off. Bradley with some nice D. Portland leading by three. And the rejection by Cousins. And he recovers it. Passes it to Bradley. And Valanciunas kicks to LeBron. A good look from Bradley. Good, and the assist goes to James. James has got his sixth assist on the night.
And thus far, they've managed to overcome an off game from him offensively.
Here's Carter Williams, and he drops in the layup off the glass.
And that's just a great individual play right through the teeth of the defense.
Fellas, I'll tell you, I was really surprised when Michael Carter Williams got traded last season. It's so hard to find point guards with his length of his steps. I mean, you just have to wonder what's going on in Philly.
And the Timberwolves making a change here. Whiteside's checked in, and Portland with a change here, too. Lamb is checked in for Bradley. Morris a screen. Somehow ignores the tight D and gets the layup. Morris has got 10 points here in the second half. A little over 2.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth quarter. Carter Williams dishes to Carroll. He feeds it to Gordon. Off target from three-point range.
You know what, though? Sometimes you can be too open. I think it may have surprised him, and that's why he missed.
Morris against Cousins from downtown. And it's Whiteside with the rebound. Whiteside's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. Gordon against Dragic. Whiteside a screen. Deep two from Carroll. The shot will not go. Now the Trailblazers take it the other way. Dragic kicks to Valanciunas. Now here's Carroll. He's guarded closely to the right side. The shot by Carter Williams. Nobody around. Drills the three-pointer.
A pretty free look from three-point range. The D forgot about him on that possession.
Dragic kicks to James. Valanciunas with a screen on Carroll. The drive by James. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two.
And the thing about LeBron James, he's really done a nice
nice job of reshaping his game over the years. I mean, every veteran goes through losing a little speed and quickness. The great ones compensate by getting stronger and more physically imposing, not to mention also their basketball IQ grows as well, just as has been the case for LeBron.
Good pick, but he just couldn't make it count.
Yeah, nice job of setting the screen by his teammate there, and I'm sure he appreciated it.
Now that's terrific defense at the rim, got right in his path.
And you know they'll be conscious of him next time they take it inside, too. I mean, that's what really good defenders do. They make you think about their presence.
Talking about the strength of LeBron now, we saw Michael Jordan do this, too. They paid a lot of attention to the body as they got older, and thus they became more sculpted. They looked more physical.
Exactly. Leaned up and altered their games a bit. Not nearly as high-flying, but just as potent and as effective.
Here's Valanciunas. Morris with the screen for Lamb. Now the pass to Morris.
You know, he's been off his game this quarter just a bit. Hasn't been able to get a whole lot to go so far. Some good play from Valanciunas in this one. He's got 10 rebounds, and the steals are starting to pile up for him also.
And Clark, he's really gotten into their heads because of it. I mean, guys are on the lookout for him, always worrying about where he is. Impeccable from the line since halftime.
No misses yet. You can't do much better than that, guys.
Minnesota calls timeout. Look at LeBron James. He's really been playing well.
He's been attacking the rim with reckless abandon. They're searching for answers. Some way they've got to figure out how to contain him.
And now Doris Burke has an update from the sidelines.
Thank you, Kevin. Well, I was able to listen in on the Timberwolves head coach talking to his team. He was riding them pretty hard for the number of silly fouls they've committed in this game. He said, listen, we need to have some defensive discipline. Stop biting on the shot fakes, stop reaching in, and stop giving them free points at the free throw line. We'll see if they'll respond, guys.
Nice piece of work there. Get yourself a little space and pull the trigger.
Kicks it out to Gordon. Carter Williams against Dragic. White side, high post, shot clock at 6, and a great assist by Carter Williams as that one goes in. Carter Williams has got his 7th assist of the game with that last one. Carter Williams against Dragic. Morris outside. LeBron left side. Falls right in. He is 8 for 11 with that shot.
And he's had an excellent performance overall from the field.
Carter Williams against Dragic. Whiteside a screen. Carter Williams kicks to Whiteside. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot 2. It's going to go on Markieff Morris.
Take a look at what Hassan Whiteside's done. 18 points, and when it comes to rebounding, he's had a nice night there, too.
He's not afraid to mix it up there in the middle, getting in there and doing a lot of the dirty work.
That was essential that he cashed in on those free throws. They're within one possession.
Time called here. The Blazers decide to talk it over. They're leading by 2. A minute 42 left in the fourth quarter. Rockets the pass to James. And the shot counts. He's fouled. It's a chance for a 3-point play.
They are just killing him on the interior.
Yeah, you can't say that with enough emphasis. I mean, the defenders are just not being aggressive enough down low. You got to play with some physicality in the paint.
Outside Gordon. Screened by Cousins. Gerald dishes to Cousins. 1:25 left in the fourth quarter. Got it. Good job in the low post. Cousins has got 4 this quarter.
And whatever intensity was lacking there in the first half, you're seeing it on display here now.
Ditto that. I mean, things have really been turned up.
Trailblazers making a switch here. Bradley's checked in. Give it up. down low. Back to LeBron. Good ball movement here by the Trailblazers. Rebound, Minnesota. Gordon inside. James covering. There's the feed to Kira. To the inside. And slammed in by Whiteside.
Give credit where credit is due right there. A terrific assist.
The Trailblazers have gone 7-15 from the floor here in the fourth. Right around 46-47%. Morris a screen. James kicks the Dragic. Morris with a screen on Carroll. Dragic the pass to Morris. Portland no good that time either.
Not a quarter to remember as far as his offense is concerned.
Yeah, you know, he's not making any kind of impact for them at that end of the court right now.
To take the lead, and two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle on a lot of contact there. That's on LeBron James.
Oh, the officials are all over that one.
Clearly a foul. I mean, didn't give him any choice but to blow the whistle. I mean, you got to play without fouling.
And the second of two is good. That ties the game up.
And you can see that even though he ties the game up, disappointed he couldn't give him the lead.
Now a timeout called by Portland. The score is tied at 85. We've got 28 seconds left to play here in the fourth. We've got 28 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
Well, I like the defense there. Right up in his grill, didn't give him a chance.
And he misses the first one. Boy, he wanted that one to fall. Taking two shots. And the second of two is good. That gives them the lead.
Not an A-plus trip to the line, but he did get them the lead.
Absolutely critical chance right here.
They need this one to go their way.
Morris a screen. Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. They're going to prolong the game here with an intentional foul.
Honestly, just doing what they have to in order to get the basketball back.
That's a good foul, though. I like that. I mean, clock management is crucial at this time of the game.
And a tough break as a second attempt at the line, no good. Here's Bradley. Oh, no good. And an intentional foul right there.
You have to foul, but I'm sure they would have liked to foul someone different.
Yeah, but Greg, they didn't really have another option. I mean, I thought they did a nice job getting it in his hands and making sure he was the guy who'd go to the line.
And so it's the Timberwolves who come out on top here. What a show they put out here at home tonight.
Tremendous work.
Wow. What a sloppy-ass game. That was some exhilarating final few moments there. That was a great ending. Can't believe we came back and got it with all those poor-ass free-throw shooters. Hassan Whiteside was somehow able to sink one. What a game. I'm going to show you all my stats, and then I'm going to end the video, but that was a hell of a game. I thought for sure we were going to get our first loss of the season, but we gutted it out, we got the win. Thanks for watching.
And was immediately on fire. That third quarter was his, and he did not hesitate to exert his will.
Just a sensational performance on a lot of...
And that wraps things up, folks. Thanks for joining us. For Shaquille O'Neal.